everybody. What is going on, the Catch fam? It is Steven here, and in today's video, we are going to break down the must-start defenses for your fantasy football teams going into Week 10. And wow, Week 10, we are really getting close to that backstretch of the season, guys. But our first defense on today's video is going to be the Arizona Cardinals going up against the Carolina Panthers. And man, Chandler Jones just became the franchise record setter for the Arizona Cardinals up against that San Francisco 49ers team. They put an absolute whooping on the San Francisco 49ers. That was a surprise. They were the underdogs in that game with Kyler Murray being injured, with DeAndre Hopkins being injured, and they said it doesn't matter. We're just going to hand it off to James Conner 50 damn times and just go after the quarterback all day long. But this Arizona Cardinals defense is one of the best in football, so I understand if you are not able to get them this week, and we've got plenty of other defenses to take a look at. But Arizona Cardinals have been very solid all year, so this was no surprise going up against San Francisco that they cooked them the way they did. 5 sacks on the day. They really made up for that absolute stinker they had against Green Bay, where they only put up 1 fantasy point. But I like them a lot going up against Carolina here. So if you have them on your team, or for some reason they're, you know, on waivers because somebody dropped them, because after that Green Bay game, it was a little scary. And then they got the bye week coming up as well pretty soon. So they might be out there in your waivers. And if they are, you need to go after them for this week. Next, we have the Steel City representing the Pittsburgh Steelers defensive unit, guys. And just as a disclosure, this is being filmed and dropped ahead of the Monday night special between the Bears and the Steelers. But I don't think that's going to negatively impact my prediction here too much, because I think the Steelers are going to get it done against the Chicago Bears unit. But this Steelers defense has been really good over the past couple weeks. And large reason for that being is that they're getting to the quarterback and making the quarterback do things that they don't want to do, right? They are hurrying them. They are making them turn the ball over. And that is what Jared Goff has been prone to doing over the past 3 to 4 weeks as well. And Jared Goff, there's already quarterback controversy in Detroit as well. But that is just a messy situation. And they are a prime candidate for being streamed against. I think this is a good situation here. One of the best streaming options you are going to be able to put into your fantasy football lineups this week. Up next, we got the Indianapolis Colts, guys. And I think there's another slam play here going up against Jacksonville, despite the Jacksonville Jaguars win over the Buffalo Bills, which was a surprise to everyone, including myself. And despite also the Colts disappointing a bunch of fantasy owners out there who put them in there thinking they were going to be a smash play and really disappointed with a weak performance, around 5 points in most fantasy football leagues. But I mean, guys, in that Jets-Colts game, the Colts were able to get to a massive lead really quickly. And I think that the defense and the offense, respectively, both just let their foot off the pedal a little bit. And the Jets were able to just attack a prevent defense, a soft defense. It didn't really matter who was on that Jets team. They were just able to do enough to drive the ball down the field, right? But, you know, the Colts unit is very strong. The reason I really love this Colts-Jags matchup is because they've got the division aspect to it. So the Colts are going to come out here, they're going to be awake, and they're going to be trying to beat up on this Jags team till the very end, right? This Jags team beat the Colts last year. So there is bad blood between these units. But also, I mean, too, with the Jaguars, one of the best things that they do is they give it to their guy, James Robinson. Well, he's banged up, so he might be there. He might be able to play, but he might be also just Carlos Hyde getting the work, right? Either way, the Colts run D is very strong. They were able to do pretty well against Michael Carter and Ty Johnson with the New York Jets. So I think this is a really good opportunity for the Colts to maybe get in the good graces of a lot of fantasy owners out there if you guys give them the chance to perform well for you again against the Jacksonville Jaguars. Up next, we got the Tampa Bay Buccaneers coming off the bye week, coming off of that really bad loss against the New Orleans Saints, where they just looked disgusting. Trevor Siemian torched him. This secondary was just lost. Tom Brady was lost. How often can you say that, right? And I think that's a good reason, good narrative reason for why I do think the Tampa Bay Buccaneers team is going to bounce back off the bye week and look really good. I think they are going to be well-prepared, locked in, focused, because Tom Brady and all those leaders on this unit are going to demand it. Bruce Arians is going to demand it. And the matchup is beautiful going up against Washington, right? Washington does have some good players. They have Terry McLaurin, they have Gibson, they have McKissick, but all of those guys are banged up that I just mentioned. And on top of that too, the Tampa Bay defense is very strong against the run, right? So Antonio Gibson is a very skeptical start if you are in a position to have him on your team. But when you look at the numbers over the past month or so, right, Tampa Bay has looked good, right? The secondary has been beat up, right? And they have been taken advantage of like they were in that New Orleans game. But 21 points the week before that against Chicago, which is another struggling offense similar to Washington. 4 points against Philly and the Eagles. Just that was not one of the better performances, but 8 and 9 the weeks before that, respectively, against Miami and New England. I think this is another really good opportunity. And again, a large reason for why I think this is an awesome play is because of the narrative and because how much I know that this Super Bowl winning team in the Tampa Bay Buccaneers are going to want to come back and prove to everyone that they still are a team to be reckoned with. Wow. Talk about a team just doing a complete 180 and also stepping up, you know, stepping up when their leader is down. I mean, the Tennessee Titans looked amazing in that Sunday night game against the LA Rams. They were underdogs in this game. They've been underdogs in the past like 3 to 4 games, guys. And what have they done? They have stepped up to the plate and gotten the job done. They have said, all right, I don't care that everybody thinks it's going to be a letdown game. I don't care that Henry is injured. I don't care that Ryan Tannehill hasn't really been throwing up a whole lot of yards and touchdown passes. We're just going to still win the game, right? That's what's just been happening. And guess what else has been happening, guys? The Tennessee Titans defense has been electric over the past 3 weeks, 16, 12, and 17. Like, we, on a consistent basis across NFL fantasy advisors or experts or whoever, right, they would tell you stay away from this Tennessee defense. They were the worst in the league, stream against them, right? But that is not the case. They have really improved ever since that Jets loss, which surprised everyone. They even had 13 points the week before that Buffalo game, right? I love this Tennessee defense. They are scrappy. They get at the quarterback. Their internal pass rush is absurdly good, led by Jeffrey Simmons, who was in Matt Stafford's face all day. But guess what? You're also going up against New Orleans, right? So you got Trevor Siemian, who has not been that good. He beat Tom Brady, obviously, but then came back and lost to Matt Ryan and the Falcons, right? Give me crying out loud, right? And then you got, at the end of the day, maybe Taysom Hill plays, right? Taysom Hill didn't really look that good coming back off the injury either. So I think this is a really good matchup regardless. And I like the Titans in this game to finally just keep kind of chugging along, man. Don't bet against the Titans because they're just getting it done. Wow. This is a game. This is another game where you were just looking at the scoreboard over the past couple of weeks and you're like, what the hell is going on in the NFL, man? Because the Denver Broncos, after trading Von Miller, everybody gave him no chance against this Dallas Cowboys team, which was looking good. Just had that big win against the Vikings without even Dak Prescott in the building. And then the Broncos come out here and throw up 190 rushing yards on this Cowboys team. And you're just like, what the hell is happening, right? I think the Cowboys are going to bounce back, man. That game seemed to be a little wacky to me. I think the Broncos just played a little bit out of their mind there. And going up against Atlanta, I get it. Atlanta just had that big-time division win against the Saints, right? Those two teams know each other. They get after each other all year long, every year, whenever they play each other. But I think the Cowboys come out here. You always have a chance at the turnover against Matt Ryan. That is just proven. It is basically baked into the recipe that you're going to get that chance. But they had 4 sacks last week, this Cowboys defense against Teddy Bridgewater. I think they can definitely get to Matt Ryan too. And this Cowboys defense, Cowboys team is going to be hyped up to get back at it because, you know, when the Cowboys lose, they're getting all the shit in the media. They got Stephen A. talking shit. They got everybody talking shit. So I think the Cowboys are going to come back out here, get hungry, and get after an Atlanta Falcons team, which is far worse in my mind than the Cowboys. Guys, here's a streaming option as well. There are a lot of defenses here that you could potentially throw out there as a stream, right? I think the Rams obviously are really good, but they've been disappointing me over the past couple of weeks, so I didn't want to include them in the video here, but I think the Patriots are another good streaming option against the Cleveland Browns, who Cleveland Browns just did absolute work against the Cincinnati Bengals, guys. But I think Baker Mayfield still didn't really shine in that game. And I think the Pats are a far superior defense than the Cincinnati Bengals. So if you had the Pats, you know, in that streaming matchup against the Carolina Panthers and you want to keep riding that wave, I don't hate that pick. I think you can still plug and play against the Cleveland Browns. This defense is going to scheme up some stuff and really create some problems for Baker Mayfield, who has not been able in his career so far to do a whole lot of things when his first or second read isn't there for him. And that's exactly what Bill Belichick has done his entire career, is take away your first or second read. So with that said, guys, this is the must-start defenses for your fantasy football leagues going into week 10. Let me know what you think about these defenses. Let me know about any defenses that are on your waivers. definitely, like always, am willing to get in those comments and let you know what I think. That said too, guys, let us know if there's been any trades in your leagues or if there's any other position starts that you have questions about at your quarterback, running back, wide receiver. Definitely willing to help out there as well, guys. While you're down there, guys, we encourage you to hit that like button, hit that subscribe button. We are on the road to 500 subscribers, guys. 500 subscribers, and that is all because of the love and support that we have been getting from the Catch Fam. So we really do appreciate whenever you guys hit that like button or hit that subscribe button. Every single one matters. And with that, guys, I hope you appreciated this video. And remember, you saw it here first at The Catch.